me to talk to him?
Nah, thank you, Captain. I think we can handle it.
Okay, I'll just watch and take notes. I'm so keen to learn.
That's my sister's house. All right, what's your badge number, huh? That's my sister in there. I'm family, hey? Do you understand?
All right, I got it. Richard Babbage?
Are you in charge? Thank God, because this stormtrooper wouldn't let me through.
I'm Agent Gromes. I'm with the ATF. Ricky, I know this is a bad time for you. I need to ask you a few questions. When was the last time you saw your sister?
I don't know. There was a barbecue here about 2 weeks ago. We had a fight.
I have an idea. I'm gonna call the cafe, order my food, and I found $250s in my wallet from, you know, going to Rogan's Shoes. I'll spend some of the 50 on my sandwich for over there. So, yeah. Oh, and I'm forgetting to tell you about those squares. Oh, what can I show you an example of? Oh, dear. Okay. Let me show you here. This is what it looks like out there today. Okay. This is what I'm talking about. Okay, say for example, this is like the walkway, and that's the corner. It takes up the whole square, and those, it's like a, oh gosh, maybe later I'll show it to you, but it takes up the whole square. It has circles on it, and it's like another square with circles on it, and those give me such anxiety when it's wet out, like raining and stuff. And snow on it, to where I feel like I'm gonna slip and fall. So yeah, there's one outside by our stop sign out there. So maybe later I'll show it to you. I just don't feel like doing that right now. I'm talking about what I was talking about on a previous video. So soon I will be going out and getting my sandwich. And later I want to test out my back and put some of these in there and everything and start the washer. So, oh, here I want. Okay, I got some more. Okay, good. So, yeah. I hope you know what I mean by those things on the ground. Those give me so much anxiety. Jeez. Alrighty.
Brian put the bombs in the mailboxes, but he didn't put them on the car.
Drafted by Lyndon Johnson and had to live in shit-ass Mexico for 2.5 years for no reason. I've had my eye socket punched in, a kidney taken out, and I got a bone chip in my ankle that's never gonna heal.
Jeez Louise, you guys, I can't stop pooping now. I was pretty constipated last night. Sorry about the TMI, and now I can't stop pooping it out.
It took you long enough.
Starting to feel tired. Maybe I'll grab my tuna melt later.
Yeah, well, you don't have to worry about me anymore. I'm out.
Bullshit.
That's bad, Santa.
Bullshit my ass.
I'm gonna get my coat on, and whatever I don't eat, I can save for later. I'm gonna grab that 50 and get going here.
Dear kid.
Yep, I'm back. I didn't get soup this time because they didn't have any of what I wanted. It came to 12:66. Here's my barbecue sauce.
I'm also sending you a t-shirt. I hope it's the best.
Hoping you can tell me the old man dropped dead of a stroke so you can stop chasing after my daughter.
Mediator made his assessment. I won't challenge.
I just hope we can put all this behind us.
Oh, we will. I may have some more good news. We may have found the car. I mean, hit Maggie.
Well, that's great.
Well, it's confirmed. It's only a matter of time when the registration leads us to the driver. We're very close.
Well, just please tell me if you hear anything.
I'll bring Jenny to your door within the hour. We can discuss a strategy for solving the problem.
Your mom is too cool.
Kelly? You're Kelly O'Connor?
Yes.
Hi, I'm Alyssa Grayson, your guidance counselor. Can I join you?
Sure.
These are from a secret admirer, although I suspect they're really from the football coach. She lives next to this particular bakery. So, how's your first day going?
Okay.
Pretty different from...
You gonna be okay?
Yeah, fine. Go.
Hi, you guys. That was fun watching, huh? I'm gonna lay down for a while. So, yeah, you'll be on the table. I gotta grab Eeyore, so... Oh, there he is. He's back. He's back in my sight. Oh, never mind. He left. So I will see you soon. I just need a nap, I guess.
You okay?
Oh, she is lying. She is covering for that son of a bitch. Dexter Larson is dirty. There's no doubt about it.
Well, I don't know.
You don't know?
What do you mean you don't know?
I'm thinking it probably was an accident. D'Souza was alone. Look, the door was locked.
What about the earring?
And the threats.
And the phone call that morning?
I don't think he did. I was wrong.
What the hell? your hands? You hurt both your hands?
No, just the left one.
Why do you have bandages on both? Right. Symmetry. Where is our future mirror?
He went home and was pretty shaken up.
I'll bet he is.
Grace under pressure. That's what I look for in a chief executive.
Can you ID this guy?
Not sure. He was wearing a ski mask.
Well, you were right about Henry Smalls.
Except I honestly thought he might be a suspect. Not the next...
The body in the grass.
Kill him. Cut off both hands. But then left them near the body?
Yeah, she and her husband both worked as curators at the prison museum in the Bastille.
Prison museum?
Captain Dupré? Il y a un détective à l'appareil. Il appelle des États-Unis. Et il peut expliquer le meurtre de Madame Baudreau.
Baudreau, comment?
Il a lu un article dans un journal à 9000 kilomètres d'ici.
Oh, si.
Captain Dupré, préfecture de police.
Bonjour.
Je m'appelle Captain Leland Stoppelmeyer.
Let's just say my whole life has been one long fucking miserable nightmare most of the time. And pure shit on a good day. Yeah, I guess there have been a few dull, bright spots here and there. Like a piece of ass.
I don't know what you're talking about. I have no idea what this shit is. You could be speaking fucking Swahili and I wouldn't know any better.
Grand Theft Auto 5.
Nah, I don't care. What can I get you?
A step car that moves, but there's a poop sump that tapes so I can build a boat.
What?
A step car that moves, but there's a poop sump that tapes so I can build a boat.
Okay. Have a seat. We can sign your clothes and get you.
A penguin. It doesn't have to be alive.
Thank you.
Like they were crazy. Found out the hard
Hi, you guys. I'm all ready for bed now. I'm going to sleep naked for a change. So, yeah. Mom, the rules, you know them. Stop fires from happening. No noises out there. Except for my computer. Don't touch that. If it's on, which it is right now. And yeah, the cat, hug and kiss her like there's no tomorrow. I'm sorry, Patty, for all this tormenting you up in heaven, too. But Mom and my friends that had died before me need to give you lots of love, because kitties like you deserve a lot of care and love, honey. That's what I believe, especially beautiful kitties like yourself. God, I love her like crazy. And I told myself, yeah, if I'm lucky to find a guy and find the right guy to where he won't harm me or whatever, and he's rich enough and doesn't have a criminal background or whatever, you know what I mean, right? Then yes, I can have a child with him. I don't know if I want to carry it myself, or I don't know how well that would be on my back. I'll tell him that worry. And so we'll have to find a very trusting surrogate, or probably adopt. You know what I mean? But adoption is okay too. Because really what I was thinking too, you know, for mental health wise, everybody needs a good restful sleep. And when people don't have restful sleep, they get lost in confusion, irritable, and stuff like that. And I hate to be like that to my kid, even to a baby. And I would probably want to adopt a kid who is outgrowing adoption, you know what I mean? Like when they're turning 18 and still have nowhere to go. So that's what I want to do for that kid. You know what I mean? So they don't become homeless, you know? Because I had watched this one Lifetime movie. What was it called? It was about Regina Louise. Okay. Just Google that name. Regina Louise. I think that's her name. And, God, I would know it when I see it. Maybe I should Google it. But, yeah, once I find it, that is the reason why that movie is the reason why I want to do this. And for that case, too, if she or him have, like, a person there that they grew close to, like, good friend they made, for example, like she fell in love with this caregiver person there, like a counselor there, and she became her mother in a sense. But if my adopted daughter has a friend she made there and they don't want to be separated, I could tell my future husband this reason too, as to why I want to take them both. So I want a big house that is not haunted, and to where they would have enough rooms for them to be put in, you know. And you know what I mean? So that gave me lots of thought. So I hope I feel better by tomorrow. I'm sorry about this dull day, guys. I've just been feeling sluggish, and I don't know what. It's like you're having COVID, but it's not COVID, you know? It's just, ugh. So, I hope I feel better tomorrow. Maybe I just need so much extra sleep. I do want to wake up before 11. Might get going at 10:30. So yeah, that's my dream now because of Regina Louise. You know what I mean? Because I don't want to separate children if they have a good long friendship bonding like that, you know? You know what I mean? Because I don't want to have them depressed when they're living with me. You know what I mean? I want them happy when they're living with me and my husband. So I've seen that movie like 3 or 4 times. But it's pretty sad here and there. I was like a little pissed off at it when I first watched it. Because those people at that care facility where she was at. God, it's just fucking damn it. I was like, fuck you people, you know. Excuse my language. I told myself I wouldn't swear I would filter, but geez. But yeah, I'll Google that movie now if it's still on Amazon Prime Movies. It's on Amazon Prime Movies, that's for sure. And it's on a Lifetime channel. So if you're on Amazon Prime and subscribe to Lifetime channel, and you'll find it there. So it's worth to watch because it inspired me to adopt, especially when kids are over 18 and outdated the SIP system. I want to do it that way. I want an unwanted child in the adoption agency. But that too, I don't want them to be psycho like that other movie, Mikey or Mickey or whatever his name was. He was like Chucky, my God. I know where that one is. That's on Peacock, I think. I'll show that one to you first, and then I'll look for the Lifetime movie. Okay, here we go. Oh, and I'm forgetting to play bingo too, so that's next after showing you the movies. You should watch it. Peacock is only like $5 a month, or I think it is. And 13 something if you want to take away the ads or something like that. I don't know. But you can Google it. So yeah, this kid is like Chucky. And I gotta be careful when I adopt kids. You know, like I was like thinking earlier today too, I could have them with me and my husband for a trial basis for 2 weeks just to see if they're not like this kid. And if we feel any red flags feeling, you know, we'll send them back. But yeah, this was a good movie. But I hope you know what I'm talking about. Okay. Now, God, I can't remember. I think it's, yes. I Am Somebody's Child. This is the movie. I Am Somebody's Child. The Regina Louise story, right here it is. And I just loved it. Again, it's pretty sad. It might piss you off like it did to me. But she fell in love with this counselor, caregiver there at that shelter. And the caregiver wanted to adopt her, but they were against it. That's another reason why I got pissed off. And yeah, so this is why I want to adopt kids now, because of this movie. So, the story of a young African girl who navigates over 30 foster homes and psychiatric facilities before age 18, and one woman, Janie, who believes in her. Yeah, this was really good. So, and she wrote a book, too. I can't remember the name of that book, but probably it's called Somebody's Child or something. I don't know, but I haven't read it yet. It's on my list to read. But yeah, okay. Again, that's my door. I wanted to show you that. Okay, I'm going to play bingo now. And then I'm going to go off to bed. I already took my pills and brushed my teeth.
B4. G49. N43. Bingo! 075. B5. Round over.
Alright, so I'm gonna go to bed now. If my app doesn't work again, the scheduled app. Good night now, and I am confused about something. I don't know if you noticed this too. Why is it that my screenshot recorder thing, you know, where I film the games, why is it audio delayed? I'm very confused with that. Like in the bowling games, it's like audio delayed. So, alright. I'm glad I won a bingo. I guess I'm lucky. Okie dokie. Good night now. Good night, Mommy. I love you. And baby girl Patty, I love you too. She would have been turning 30 this year, guys. I don't care how old she is. She's going to still be my baby, just like how I'm going to still be Mom's baby. Like, for example, if she'd be 172, and I'd be, you know, 142. I bet she'll think of me as still her baby girl. You know what I mean, right? I should check to see if it will be snowing, but I don't know if I want to turn on my hyperlapse at midnight, to be honest with you, because I haven't been feeling good today. I don't want my sleep disturbed. And with that too, I'm gonna take non-drowsy Claritin so my nose won't get fucked up. I'll just take one. So, especially if I'm gonna dream about Patty, if I would, you know. A few times, I don't know if I do remember this, but it felt so real. I was like laying in bed and I felt her jump up and I opened my eyes, just a little tiny sliver, and I saw her. And I go, Patty, 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 and I'm like squeezing her and hugging her. And, oh, don't let me go, honey. Oh, Patty. I wanted to take a video of me, but then I was like, oh my god, what if I let go of her and she disappear, you know, like poof. Like, fucking damn it. Some of those dreams I remember, some no, but oh, Patty, stay with me, baby girl, stay. Oh, fucking damn it. I want to hug her and hold her forever and ever and ever. But, you know, just like humans, they don't want to be hugged too long either, you know. They don't want to be snuggled too much. To be like, meow! Like that. I go, darn it, Patty. I missed you so much. I gotta hug and kiss you like this and make up for the missing. Gonna be 14 years now. Hugs, 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 kisses, 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 kisses. Yeah, 14 years, she'll be gone. July 1st. Same with Mom. February 15th for her. But Lord, that is so cool that I think I dreamt that like two or three times. I fucking love that cat, you guys. Alrighty. Those are my videos in the background.
Until he was examined by medical examiner Dr. G. After proving that his injuries were not caused by an automobile or physical assault, Dr. G has determined that Daniel was not killed as a result of a crime. But she has discovered that the victim had an inexplicable propensity for falling down. Could that have something to do with his death? After taking samples of Daniel's body fluids and finding both heart and lungs normal, Dr. G removes his liver.
Yeah, his liver looks alcoholic.
He's got looking at it, she can tell the most basic questions are puzzles.
We didn't see a penis, we didn't see a vagina, there's no internal organs, you couldn't see the sex.
Can Dr. G find the evidence needed to put a killer behind bars? Then, Henry Clark drops dead moments after coming home from the store.
The groceries were still in the plastic bag. He never put them away.
Were warning signs overlooked?
We've got some funny marks here that look like needle puncture marks in his left arm.
And could his death have been prevented? Altered lives. Baffling medical
here,
mysteries.
A little bit of high blood pressure medicine. Instructions on losing weight and exercising. Could have really helped this fella.
Now, Dr. G can reconstruct the chain of events leading to Henry Clark's collapse in his bedroom. Events stretching over years. Earlier in his life, possibly when he was quite young, Henry Clark developed high blood pressure or hypertension. Although it is a common ailment, many of its causes remain a mystery.
You don't really know what causes it. It's probably a mix of a lot of things, genetic and environmental.